Review code provided by WayForward for ladiesgamers.com. Shantae and most of her pals have been invited to the resort of Arena Town for an all-expenses-paid vacation. This is in exchange for participating in the Half Genie Festival. However, in their debut performance, all the Half Genies but Shantae vanish. It's up to Shantae to explore the mysteries of the Sunken City to rescue her new friends. The Shantae games are 2D platformers, with this game going back to the Metroidvania-type format, unlike Half Genie Hero, which was levels-based. As the entirety of this game takes place on the one island. She starts out only with her normal hair whip attack, but as you explore the Sunken City, you'll find labyrinths, dens of evil, where the other half genies are being held. Once freed, each girl will give you a new fusion transformation that'll allow you to complete the rest of the dungeon, beat the boss, and explore further in the Sunken City. There are 5 of these abilities in total, such as the dash newt that is very similar to the monkey from previous games, allowing you to air dash and climb walls. These transformations are tied to different buttons to use their abilities like ZR to newt dash, or in the case of the gastro drill and sea frog, pressing down towards dirt or water respectively. As such, there's no need to transform back as Shantae does so once the ability is done, or after pressing Y with the bash tortoise's charge. Between labyrinths, you'll go on a small quest to find a new fusion stone that'll let Shantae borrow the recently rescued half genie's magic. These 4 dancers use magic but have their own abilities that usually have more than one function, like temporarily seeing previously invisible platforms or enemies, or reviving dead trees and bringing statues to life while also recovering your hearts. While progression is in a certain order, it's blocked off by the abilities you don't have yet, not just for access to dungeons, but also extra rooms, the pathways between different areas, and the caves. Though it's all one island, it is divided into various sections, with loading screens between. These are roughly 10 seconds, and are more annoying if you're just trying to fill the map, or accidentally charge up your tortoise spin in a vertical room. Thankfully, you unlock warp points between most of these, so you won't have to make your way around the whole island all the time. As you go across your travels, you'll find caves that usually have a heart squid sitting painfully out of reach, though you can come back later with the right ability to obtain them. Like previous games, you can take them to the squid smith to melt them into heart holders, although you may feel bad about doing so later. You still have the option to use gems you found to purchase consumables, permanent upgrades like shampoo for attack power, or items that require magic to use. Later on with more money, you can upgrade these items further, such as throwing 3 boomerangs instead of 1. Personally, I found with all the new abilities Shantae has at her disposal, I rarely use the items, if at all. Still, it's good to have them there, and in New Game Plus they are likely more useful. Defeating monsters may reward you with the usual gems, hearts or food, which can all drop quite frequently, but this game introduces monster cards, of which there are 50. After collecting a certain number of a particular card, anywhere from 1 to 10, you can equip it with 3 slots total. These are various buffs from an increase to a particular form's power, lessening the magic use on a specific item like rockets, or they can be things like increasing the amount of hearts a drop and item shop discounts. More powerful ones can be acquired through exchanging nuggets with NPCs and towns. These can be freely swapped over in the pause menu, allowing you to change your strategies in new areas or even in a boss fight. Though be careful when getting rid of a speed increase as you will notice the difference very quickly. The game is pretty easy. I mean, I should know, I was able to beat it. Though Shantae can die, taking you back to your last save, there are plenty of heart and food drops. It has that Breath of the Wild problem where you can just pause and stuff your face to heal. I for one have no self-control if a game gives me options to make things easier. Spikes and pits will cause you to reset the room, taking off some health, but since it's just the room, even in the very few sections that require platforming skill, it doesn't take long to get past. The bosses themselves are mostly easy, with some of the last few disappointingly so. Once you beat in the game, you'll unlock New Game Plus. This mode gives Shantae less defense, more magic, and a new outfit the whole time. Forgoing heart upgrades in your game plus is probably the only way to get a challenge, as then touching many enemies can be an instant kill. Opening up the game, you'll be treated with a wonderful opening animated by Studio Trigger. Meanwhile, other cutscenes are done by KU. Of course, they aren't as spectacular as the opening, but are still very nice. The rest of the game looks quite pretty. It seems they've gone back to a flatter look, though there are still different background layers. Still, the art is as colourful and fun as ever. A few areas had some good tunes that made me stop for a minute to listen to the music. There is some voice acting in this game, but strangely it's only partly. A character might speak one sentence, then go to grunts or complete silence. I find this especially strange as 2 of WayForward's most recent games have more voice acting than this. There's plenty of amusing dialogue, so it's a shame it didn't get the same treatment that River City Girls or Vitamin Connection did. The controls felt very smooth, and outside of the loading screens between areas I had no technical issues. It took me a bit under 8 hours to finish the game, though an hour of that was wandering around as I assumed I couldn't go somewhere I was meant to. I wish it was longer purely because I'd rather play more of my new abilities and start the game over. Though I will have to, as I can't get 100% on my first save file, because late in the game there's a section that gets locked off permanently. That and the intermittent voice acting are the only complaints I have about this game. An option to mark things on the map would have been nice, but the world is small enough that it's not hard to remember things. It's terribly hard to resist the siren call of this game. Playing through it, I might put it down and then 2 minutes later immediately pick it back up. I had a really fun time with this game, and I give Shantae and the Seven Sirens a 9 out of 10. Be sure to check out latestgamers.com for other handheld reviews, news, and guides. Bye! Groovy!